So today we're doing something a little different. We're going to alternate between singing some worship songs and having an open mic time for you guys to share what God's doing in your life. So we're calling it a praise, prayer, and open mic Sunday. So we'll do a couple songs, then have an open mic, do a couple more songs, have an open mic. So for the open mic times, if you forward on to the questions, there you go. These are the questions. And so if you choose to volunteer to share out there, Frank's going to run the wireless mic around to you. And you can just pick one of these questions to share on. The first one is, how have you seen God answer prayer recently? Secondly, what amazing thing have you seen God do recently? What is God teaching you from Scripture? How can we pray for you? Or how can we pray for something that's going on in the world without getting political? All right, so no politics, but we can pray for world events and what's going on. So does that make sense? We've done it before, but it's been probably a year or so. So, and I'll have those questions up when it's time for the open mic again. So you could be thinking about what you want to share. And from there, just let's just go to God's Word, and we're going to sing and worship a little bit, all right? So this is 1 Chronicles 16. It says, let the whole earth sing to the Lord. Each day proclaim the good news that he saves. Publish his glorious deeds among the nations. Tell everyone about the amazing things he does. Great is the Lord. He is most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods. The gods of other nations are mere idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty surround him. Strength and joy fill his dwelling. Amen. Let's go to him in prayer. Thank the Lord. Lord, we thank you this morning for being here with us. Lord, for choosing us and saving us and allowing us to be a part of your kingdom and to enjoy your presence. God, we thank you for who you are and all you've done. God, you're a great God. You're majestic and holy. We just want to praise you this morning, God. We humble ourselves before you, recognizing that we're sinners. We need you. Thanking you for sending your son so that we could be forgiven and free. Pray, fill us with your spirit. Help us worship you right now. In Jesus' name. Amen. All right, if you're comfortable standing, please stand on up, and we're going to sing together.
Just as you are to worship.
tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. Now is the time. One day every tongue will confess you are God. One day every knee will bow. Still the greatest treasure remains for those who gladly choose you now. One day every tongue will confess you are God. This is Psalm 145, 3 through 6. It says, great is the Lord, he is most worthy of praise. No one can measure his greatness. Let each generation tell its children of your mighty acts. Let them proclaim your power. I will meditate on your majestic, glorious splendor and your wonderful miracles. Your awe-inspiring deeds will be on every tongue. I will proclaim your greatness. So let's proclaim his greatness right now as we sing this one. And the land.
is our God. Sing with me, agree. Is our God. Oh, we'll say how great is our God. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God.
God. All right, you may have a seat. It's time for our open mic time. So Frank's going to grab the mic. The questions are up there. So we just need a volunteer to choose one and be the first to share. All right? Nobody wants to get it started. But I know somebody will. Anybody, somebody, anybody? Oh, Becky. All right. Way to go, Becky. Towards the beginning of the alphabet, so we could just go alphabetically.
Good morning. Good morning. I'm Becky. I'm part of a prayer group that prays quite a bit, and I've been really, really blessed this year and every year that we've prayed together, but the thing that really stood out this year for me was that we had been praying for a long time for my son. He had been in school for a long time, and it was taking a long time for him to get a job after school, his first job. And he actually, it was like, took a year or two. I kind of lost count. But he went back to his job that he had been doing while he was in school, and the same people that he had worked with before were not there, and it was kind of a mess and caused a lot of heartache for him. And then, I don't know, he finally, after taking some tests for the city that we didn't know if that would lead to anything, he finally got a job in February, and we were very, very excited. And it's got good benefits, and
that's
very
awesome.
Proud of him, and we're very thankful to God. And I still get excited about it, clear back in August.
Yeah, that's awesome. Well, yeah, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Thank you for everybody that prayed for him.
Yes, awesome. So good, so good. Rod, who wants to go next? Darlene.
So I'm Darlene, and I think some of you know that in June, I had two car accidents, 2 weeks apart. And God, the amazing thing that he has done was protected me. The accident on 315, three car accident, nobody got hurt. When the tree fell in front of the road and I hit the tree, I had very little injuries. God's protected me financially. He's protected me physically. So I'm just so thankful for everything he's done. June was a rough month, but he carried me through.
That's awesome. Thank you. Thank you, Darlene. That's awesome. Do get hard times, but he does bring us through. Oh, Cindy, thank you.
Hi, I'm Cindy. And most of us, I think, would have somebody in their family, whether it be a spouse or children or grandchildren or close friends, that we have been praying for a long time, that they would come to know the Lord and know his wonderful love for them. And the other day I was just reminded, as I was reading, and this is taken from Jeremiah 24:7, and it says, I will give them a heart to know me. Thank you. Oh, thanks, Frank. I will give them a heart to know me, that I am the Lord. They will be my people, and I will be their God, for they will return to me with all their heart. And I was just comforted by that, because so often I find myself feeling like, what can I do? I need to be doing something more. Just feeling like a little bit of heaviness, feeling like there's something that I could do to make it happen, you know, because we so desperately want our loved ones to know him and be with him forever. And just to know that, thank you, I'll grab it in a second. sorry.
I have enough hands.
I just have to look at the words. That he says, I will give them a heart to know me, that yeah. I am the Lord. That he even does that he will prepare their hearts. And that's something that we can't do. We have to just, you know, let it go and trust him. Be desperate and be constant in prayer, but to have the trust in the Lord that he is the one who does the work and that he is going to allow those people to know him, because that's his plan. That's his beautiful plan. What kind of God do we serve? Isn't he amazing? His love is just so incredible. And I'm so grateful to be his child and to be able to worship with all of you.
That's awesome. Thank you. That's wonderful. Right. Who else? I know there's more of you out there. Kim.
I just want to thank God for how well VBS went. It was so encouraging to see all the kids and the families come. And one of the highlights for me was the Sunday afterwards where the families came and Nick was there asking questions and throwing out candy. And just how many of the kids that remembered things they had taught.
Yeah.
I mean, I was so encouraged because I knew that God put words in their hearts that were going to stay. And even though they were really little, they had learned, they had retained. So I was praising God for that.
Awesome. Thank you, Kim. Awesome. Lex.
And just to go off of VBS, so I don't know if any of you knew, but the week before, it showed we were supposed to have rain every single day before VBS. And every single day it didn't rain, which was just a miracle in our plannings. And, you know, we really wanted to have everybody outside and in the tent, and we wanted to make sure decorations didn't get blown away or rained out or anything like that. And it just God was so faithful in that, because it did. It said it was supposed to rain every single day of the week, and every single day, by the time VBS started, there was no clouds on the horizon, which was fantastic.
Yeah, praise the Lord. Thank you.
We're going to continue with this children's theme here. Yes. So a lot of you probably know that this last week, Nick was on a work trip, and so we had a week without him here. And Thursday was a tough day. that night, our girls, they looked at me and they said, "Mommy, we want to help you clean up since Daddy's not here," with a happy heart. And I was like... And they stayed up an hour after their bedtime, and they helped me clean up the family room, do the dishes. We used up half of the soap, but you know, it was successful, and take out the trash. And it was just very, very sweet. And they were exhausted afterwards, and then they refused to go to bed without reading the Bible that night.
Oh,
and
wow.
just their desire and want to serve the Lord and want to know him more. It's just very encouraging, and that actually leads into a prayer request for my kids and then our entire children's ministry, which is to be praying this next ministry year for them and their hearts to be open to him and wanting to serve him, and to, like Kim said, to hide that in their heart and to be able to have that their entire life and have a lasting, saving relationship with Jesus Christ. And please be praying for them, because their hearts, they're moldable right now, and we want to see Jesus in the center of their hearts. And we've got a big children's ministry back there right now, and it's going to be an exciting year.
Well, let's pray right now. Yeah. Does someone want to pray? And any volunteers to pray for that? We could have Jess pray for it. Oh, Julie will pray for it. Thank you, Julie.
Dear Heavenly Father, we just are so grateful for all the children that you have blessed us with here in this church this year and throughout all the years, Lord. We just want to lift up this next ministry year to you, pray for each and every child that's going to pass through these doors and be taken care of, whether it's in the infant nursery all the way up through KIC. And Lord, I just pray for their hearts, Lord, that they would have soft hearts and open to your word, that they would retain just little pieces of your scripture that will just stick in their hearts, that they're just going to know and know that they're loved by you, Lord. Pray for each and every teacher and ministry helper there in the children's ministry. Help them to be patient and to love on each child, and help us to communicate your love, your word, in truth, and accurately. Help us to connect with the children, and just to point them to you, Lord. Pray for your protection over just the whole church, but especially over all the families there. Lord, we know that Satan would like to get at these children, and so we just pray your hand of protection over them, that they're that they would not fall in the traps of believing lies from the enemy, but that they would be just in tune with your truth. Pray that your spirit would be over them, protecting them, and just that they would grow up, as Jess said, just to be loving you and serving you all the days of their lives, and just have that wonderful relationship with you. We pray for each one to be saved at an early age, according to your plan, so that they can just grow your kingdom, Lord, and affect others for you as well. Just pray in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Julie. Right, if the band can come up, that would be awesome. And if someone else wants to go right now, you can. Anybody else want to share? We're going to have another, Linda Charlton. We're going to have another open mic time after a couple songs too, so.
A recent prayer was this Wednesday. My twin granddaughters had surgery for their cleft lips. And it's very complicated, and it's amazing what they can do. But everything went very well. The doctor was very pleased, so thank you for praying for them. I was kind of dreading the evening because they put the girls in two different rooms. So the mom, Sarah, my daughter-in-law, stayed in one room with one twin, and I stayed in the other room. And you know how hospitals are. You don't get any sleep. So I was kind of dreading that because that's just not fun. But I was like, you know what, God, do what you want to do. You used to help me on campus when I first became a believer and had to stay up and do all-nighters and that type of thing. So, you know, whatever you want to do. So it went really well, and I was very, very pleased and grateful for that. And then I helped out with we helped out with one of the twins for a couple days at home also. So they're healing nicely. They have a much more complicated surgery in December, which I'll let you all know about, of course, to replace the skin that's missing in their palate. So that'll be in December. But I wanted to share, when we were in New York, we got away for a little while, the beginning of the month, and it was supposed to be a family vacation, ended up just being me and Charlie, and which ended up being a blessing, even though I was kind of mad at him because there were circumstances that made it so the whole family couldn't come. And so I was like, okay, I guess God had something planned here. So we had a very relaxing time, and it was very wonderful. And I was very stressed out before we went, and I was talking to God and spending time with him, and just felt like he was saying, if you're too stressed out, you're not trusting me. It's not all about you. You don't have to do everything that you see could be done or think needs to be done. So it was very humbling, and I'm trying to, my friend Julie Cornelius, that I'm not seeing here, was talking about a lady who said, if you have a amount of time blocked out for rest, and someone says, hey, are you busy tonight? Yeah, I am. I need that time. I have to refresh. I have to regroup. I have to spend time with my mom who's living with us. And I can't just keep running. And it's hard for me to do that and just believe that trust that God's working there. He's the one in charge, and it's not me. So appreciate your prayers for any of that. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Let's stand up and sing a couple more here. The same God who never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out, working all things out. Oh yes, I will lift too high in the lowest valley. Bless your name. Oh yes, I will sing for joy when my heart is heavy. Oh my dear, yes, I will. Same God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out, working all things out. Oh yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Bless your name. Oh yes, I will sing for joy when my heart is heavy. Oh my dear, oh yes, I will. Oh my dear, yes, I will. And I choose to praise. by the name of O'Neill. Nothing can stand against, and I choose to pray. Stand again, I choose to pray. To glorify, glorify the name of all names. And nothing can stand against, and I choose to pray. To glorify, glorify the name of all names. And nothing can stand against. Praise him. Amen. All right. This is 2 Timothy 1, 9 and 10. It says, our God saved us and called us to a holy calling, not because of our works, but because of his own purpose and grace, which he gave us in Christ Jesus before the ages began, and which now has been manifested through the appearing of our Savior, Christ Jesus, who abolished death and brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Let's praise the one who abolished death. Oh, praise the name. I cast my mind to Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. His body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still and all alone. Oh, praise the name of the Lord our God, oh, praise his name forevermore, for endless day. We will sing your praise, oh Lord, oh Lord our God. Then on the third, at break of dawn, Son of heaven rose again. Oh, trampled death, where is your sting? The angels roar for Christ the King. Sun shall pierce the night. and I will rise among the saints. My gaze transfixed on Jesus' face. Thank the Lord. All right, why don't you have a seat again? Time for another open mic time. There's the questions again. So feel free to go for it. Andrea, thank you.
Well, yesterday, myself and many members of the basic group were able to go to Miss Dolly's 90th birthday party. She sends her love to everyone. She hasn't been able to come in quite a while. And even within the last month, she fell and has taken a little notch down. But she was still Miss Dolly. We just had a real fun time with her whole family, her children, her grandchildren, and her great-grandchildren. Just all came together, and because of the heat, we were all inside the house, which was very cozy, but much cooler than their really pretty backyard. And so I just want to remind everybody to keep Dolly in her prayers. And as importantly, keep her family in the prayers. Miss Dolly is quite a formidable woman, if anybody has really ever gotten to know her. And her family has taken such good care of her for years and years now. And she's still Miss Dolly. She's still eating her gummy bears. And she just was there as queen of the whole party. And so just keep her family in prayers as they continue to take care of her. A lot, you know, she's always been a handful. We love her so much, but she's 90 years of fire. Years ago, she showed me a picture of herself in her younger years in Detroit, go-go boots and all. Yes. And in her heart, she's still wearing those go-go boots and mini skirts, guys. Between her walker and her wheelchair, she's in her heart, she's still walking her go-go boots and just loving everybody and her family and God. And we should just keep her in our minds. And Frank here has just been so faithful making her feel that she's still part of our family, even though she's not sitting in her back seat over there on Sunday morning and just having everybody love on her. So just don't forget that even if somebody doesn't show up, doesn't mean they don't want to. Sometimes they can't. And just try to, somewhere in your life, extend that love to someone who can't get out. So, again, happy birthday, Miss Dolly.
Yeah, someone want to pray for Dolly and fam? Got a volunteer prayer warrior?
I will.
Frank can, yeah, awesome.
Dear Heavenly Father, we pray for Dolly. Ashley, Andrea, you said it all. We just ask for grace for Terry and Rochelle as they care for her. We just pray, Lord, that you... Dolly is the center of many people's world. She affects many different people. And we thank you, Lord. Mm-hmm. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Right. Right. Anybody else? I know Chris. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm going to tackle the one about teaching from Scripture. I'm going to try to take a whole bunch of scattered thoughts here and put them into something sensible. So the last year I've been trying to repetitively go through the Gospels, and at the same time also I've been doing a lot of studying in some of Paul's books, primarily where our small group went through Romans, and then I've been trying to study also through Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, and Colossians. And the one thing that God has really impressed on my heart is it kind of boils down to our stubborn hearts, God's way or my way. And many times I will confess that I want to do it my way. And today we think that, you know, you read back about Adam and Eve and we think, oh, we've progressed so much today and, you know, we've made so much progress. Well, actually, we have not. It's the same sin then as it is now. It's, you know, we don't want to follow God's way. We want to believe the lie that, oh, we can do it our way and be happy and be better. And, you know, sometimes we look around at our world around us and see the things that are going on and we get frustrated, but we have to examine our own heart and realize that we've all got a sin problem, and that's a stubbornness to want to do things our way and not God's way. And in my business, I get to go out and meet a lot of different people and work with a lot of different people. And, you know, just like I was before God brought me into his kingdom and gave me the opportunity to come to Christ, there's a lot of people that really are stubborn and really need Jesus. And it's our job to be a light to them and to share the gospel with them, to share God's love with them. And I need to do that more. And I need to really focus on, you know, reaching people for Christ, because just like I was lost at one point, so are they. So thank you.
Thank you, Chris. That's awesome. Cam.
So I could use some prayer. Several weeks ago, I had a medical issue pop up, and we thought it had resolved, and yesterday it reared its ugly head again. So just some prayer. No details, but just some prayer for that. So.
Okay. Awesome. Who wants to pray? Chris will pray. Thank you.
Lord God, we lift up our dear brother Cam, and Lord, we just pray in the name of Jesus over his body. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you would just come upon him and just put strength in his body, that you would heal everything that's ailing him, Lord, and just lift him up and strengthen him. Pray that also through this that you would just open his heart more and more to you, and that he would just come to know you in even a deeper way, Lord. We know his heart loves you, but just take him even further and closer to you. We just, again, pray for complete healing and strength in his body, and we ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen.
I wanted to add to that. Lord, thank you, Lord, for all the years that Cam gave to the church, all the different projects over the decades, all the different times that he was laying his body down to serve the church. In Jesus' name, amen. Mary.
Just want to ask for prayer for my mother. she's battling with dementia, and it's getting a little bit worse. And so a few weeks ago, we put her back on hospice. So they've been really good taking care of her and filling in the voids when we can't be down there. But anyway, she's just struggling. And so my sister and I and family are, you know, just trying to get through the day or help her out and bring her back to where she is or should be. And so anyway, she could use your prayers. Thank you.
Someone like to pray? Mary's mom. Linda.
Thank you, Linda.
Father God, we thank you that you are in control and you know what's going on with Mary's mom. And we just pray for the situation there. You guide Mary and her sister to know how to best help her mom. And thank you. Please bless all the hospice workers who do tireless work and care so much for people. We just ask that you would hold her mom closely, comfort her, comfort the family, and just give them wisdom on how to best serve her for the rest of her life, Lord. And we thank you for her mom and her sweet spirit and all that she does for others and has done for others, God. We just pray for her comfort and joy. In Jesus' name, amen.
Here you go, Ryan.
Sorry, I'm not really sure where to start. I'd just like to share a verse that has gotten me by, I think us by. We've made big strides, I think, in the last year to become, like, from casual Christians to just all in. And just thank you to everybody to welcoming us into this church family here in the last couple of years. We've gone through, since making that stride, through several trials in our lives, whether they seem, you know, big to us, but maybe small to some. It just, you know, when raising a young family and then going through just thing after thing, just things building up. So this passage is from James 1, verses 2 through 4. And it's, "Consider it a great joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you experience various trials, because you know that the testing of your faith produces endurance. And let endurance have its full effect, so that you may be mature and complete, lacking nothing." And so that's just been a great verse that has given us a lot of hope. And
that's awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ryan.
It made me cry before I'm about to talk. So many of you know we've been thinking about schooling a lot, like beginning of January, because our son's going to go into kindergarten. And the way that the world has been going, it's kind of scary. So since January, we have been praying and praying and praying nonstop. And it's just crazy how God has been working when we didn't even know he was. Because we were looking into things that, you know, we could probably swing, we could probably do. I even thought about homeschooling. I tell you, it's not my thing. a lot of people can do it. I can't. But, I mean, we just glazed over this one, like, no, we're not going to do this one. It's the most expensive option. Little did we know, God told us, you know, go there. Send him there. And we listened. He has a full scholarship.
Wow.
Like, they just started that this year, guys. This year. And he starts tomorrow. And all of our prayers got answered over that. And it's exciting. It's amazing. So.
Oh, praise the Lord. That's awesome. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
What's that? Yeah, go for it. Yeah, still need prayer. Yeah, that's for sure.
I apologize, but what's your son's name?
Everett.
Everett? Okay.
Everest. Okay, sorry. Lord God, we lift up Ryan and Trinity, and just we praise your name for just what a blessing, Lord. What a blessing in an answer to prayer. And Lord, we just lift up little Everest as he will begin just a new chapter in his little life. And thank you so much that you are looking out for him. And we just continue to pray for protection over the family and just your their heart for you, and that you would just draw them even closer to you, and that you would just use this opportunity in a mighty, mighty way, Lord, and just use Ryan and Trinity and their family to reach others for your glorious kingdom. And again, we just praise your holy name, and it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Mine's going to be way, way shorter because I don't have many words. Most of them are out of here, so it's good. In Psalm 55, verse 22, it's just one of my favorite sections. Cast your burden on the Lord, and he will sustain you. And everybody knows it goes on. It's a very familiar verse, but I just love how it's just, I'm one of those people who needs something to do. You know? Tell me what to do. I'll do it. One of the hardest ones for me is be still and know that I'm God. Okay, I can do that. I keep trying. But, you know, cast my cares. Now I can do that. I can write a list. I can cast cares, you know. And so it's reality-based for me. But I love that it's followed by that promise. You know, he will sustain you. And so I just really count on that regularly, and I just encourage everybody else too, because there's no he doesn't let us down. He doesn't necessarily do stuff the way we expect, but he never lets us down.
Yes, thank you. Great.
So, hello. I'm going to share some scripture as well. Mine's going to be really short. It's not even going to be a complete verse, in fact, but I've been going through the book of Corinthians, 1 Corinthians, and in chapter 14, verse 12b, it says, strive to excel in building the church. And this, you know, just kind of jumped out at me, I mean, because it's short and it's sweet, and it says so much. So almost, well, probably about 38 years ago, Joanne and I left Dayton, and came to Columbus. And so we actually prayed before we left Dayton, not for a church, but for a Bible study. And we moved Thanksgiving holiday, and God introduced us to a Bible study. And this man led that Bible study almost 40 years ago. It's ironic that Mike is here on Open Mic Day. But he's not the only one that was there. Eric Swank was there as well.
Yes, yes, awesome.
So this is kind of like a family reunion. And as far as building up the church, these men have done a wonderful job, and we just appreciate it.
Yes, thank you, brother. Oh, that's awesome. It's awesome. Mike was my first ministry leader with the usher ministry when I was trying to get over my painful shyness. So he helped me through that with his smile and taught me how to be welcoming to people, so good life lesson. All right, anybody else? I got over here. Brock.
I will try to keep this short. I could tell you the things that God has been trying to teach me over the past year and so. Could probably fill a book. So just lots of things I've been thinking about. One has been contentment. That seems to be a big lesson God's been trying to teach me, being content with what he has blessed me with and knowing that he has blessed and knowing all the things he's blessed me with. It's just, it can get hard sometimes when you're looking at the world and you see the things in it and it's like, but God has been good. He's real good. He has blessed me with I've been telling some of you guys this, like, had a job, got laid off, let go last summer. Then I got another job that was really bad for me, anxiety-inducing, all that nasty stuff. And then God got me a new job this summer. And the next week, after I turned in my 2 weeks' notice, the next week, I found out the lab I was working in was shutting down. And so, like, next month. So, there. And so just thinking about Scripture, it's like how God's ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. And so that's just something personal. And also just thinking about the world and with election season coming up, not going where you think I'm going, but I just thinking about where Jesus told his disciples, my kingdom is not of this world. Yeah, amen. If it was, my disciples would be fighting. And with all the crud going on in this country and in this world, knowing that we serve a sovereign Lord who holds the heart of the king in his hand, that, I mean, it's like, yes, we need to be prayerful in how we vote and prayerful for our country because this is the place he's placed us in. But also knowing ultimately our citizenship is in heaven and we are just sojourners in this land and that God is the one who is in control of history and nothing surprises him, nothing shakes him off his throne. No matter who wins the elections in November, God's still on the throne. God is still sovereign king of the universe. And he's got us in his hand. He will take care of us ultimately in heaven, but also here. And it's just, and I can find great comfort in that. Just thinking about some of the things like the Connors talking about, it's like, yeah, it's scary sending it when trying to figure out what to do with your kids, sending them to a school. That's scary. But God is in control. God will take care of us. Even if we lose our lives, he has us in his hand.
Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you, Brock. That's awesome. Anybody else? Last chant, Lex, go for it. And if the band could come up. You can't come up. You can stay there, Lex.
I just wanted a quick prayer request for our family. We have a lot of changes coming this year with new baby and Nathan's new employment. If you could just be praying for safety for him just every day. You guys are incredible at helping us, and we know we always have a church family to lean on when we need to. And just if you could just be praying for us as everything lays out through the end of the year and as Nathan keeps on this new journey. Yeah. That's it.
Someone want to pray?
I will.
All right, thanks, Frank.
Dear Heavenly Father, we do pray for Nathan and his new job as a police officer. We pray for protection. We pray for guidance. We thank you, Lord, that you got him this job, and you're rewarded his faithfulness. We pray for the new child coming into their lives. We pray for health. and wisdom how to raise their children. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you. Anything else burning on your hearts? One more. Chris has got one. Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you.
Dear Heavenly Father, I just would like to lift up the leaders in our country. We're called to pray for them, no matter whether we agree or disagree with them. And so I just want to lift up specifically our leaders. I lift up our President, Joe Biden, and just pray as he's just phasing out and just obviously an elderly man, but just shows he needs you just as much as I do and everyone here needs you. And I pray that he would come to face-to-face with you and come to know you as his Lord and Savior. And I pray for the potential candidates to become our next president, Kamala Harris and Donald Trump. Just pray for each one of them, Lord, that they would truly come to know you as our Lord and Savior and that you would just do a mighty work in their life. I pray for our state and local leaders, also that they would come to know you and that they would lead by your truth. And Lord, I want to lift up Darby Creek and just pray for our elders, pray for Greg and Charlie and Skip and Frank and Nick, and also pray for our deacons, Jamie and Darlene, and all of our small group leaders. Just pray, Lord, that you would abundantly bless them, that you would give them strength, that you would encourage them, that you would bless their family, Lord, and that you would just give them wisdom to lead whatever area of responsibility they have, and that you would bless them and bless Darby Creek through them, Lord, and that we would just be a light to the world around us. And we just pray these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Chris. That's awesome. All right. If there's nothing else, let's stand up. Let's stand on up. We'll sing one more song before we call it a day. All sufficient merit. Sufficient merit shining like the sun, a fortune I inherit by no work I have done. My righteousness I forfeit at my Savior's cross. Sufficient merit did what I could not. In love it condescended, eternal now in time. A life without a blemish, a maker to time. The law could never save us, our lawlessness had won. Until the pure and spotless Lamb had finally come. And it's done, it is finished.
Finished, no more did I owe. Fit in
sufficient merit, firm in life and death. The joy of my salvation shall be my final breath. When I stand accepted before the throne of God, I'll gaze upon my Jesus and thank Him for the cross. I thank Him for the cross. It is done. It is finished. No more did I owe. Paid in full. All sufficient.
Praise the Lord.